Mold. It's gross, it's ugly, and it's unsafe.
She said, "Looks like you were like a canary in the coal mine."
Retired Lieutenant Alan Doucette served aboard two Canadian destroyers, HMCS Athabascan and HMCS Iroquois, between 2006 and 2009, and he came away sick.
They said it was just a seasonal flu, chest cold, whatever they wanted to chalk it up to.
But it was more than that, and he began to look around for a cause.
There was black mold pretty much in all the living quarters, like in the corners and stuff like that. It looked like somebody used black spray paint and just, you know, mist or whatever.
His illness was diagnosed as hyperactive airway disorder, brought on by exposure to mold and diesel fumes, something Veterans Affairs now recognizes as the reason his naval career ended in 2012.
I am not aware of any long-term reports of any kind of illness associated with mold.
Last year, CBC News reported on mold and air quality concerns aboard the warships. And this was, at the time, the Navy's official line.
We have absolutely no concern about the mold in the ships.
But now, it's this.
We've had an ongoing concern with mold in the frigates now since we entered into the pre-work for the modernization program.
That modernization project was a $4.3 billion multi-year refit of the Navy's 12 frigates. The program did not include an upgraded ventilation system despite previous mold concerns. The Navy is now being forced to retrofit those changes into each ship, costing taxpayers $50 million.
So every indication that we have today is that it has worked to improve the system.
But they aren't entirely sure. DND has deployed a hazardous health assessment team to HMCS Winnipeg. It will conduct specialized air quality tests between now and the end of the month. Eventually, all warships will be checked, in addition to day-to-day assessments.
For air quality monitoring, we have our physician assistants on board who always conducts air quality monitoring.
So to test just how diligent the Navy has been on a day-to-day basis, CBC News asked under access to information for copies of previous air quality tests and health assessments related to mold on warships. 9 months later, and we're still waiting. Marie Brewster, CBC News, Ottawa.